shame.
I wish I knew.
Today, and it's just majorly about how to start your career in the tech industry. This content is going to be really interesting, and I'll try my best to break everything down and be simple about it. Keep watching. If you've not subscribed, please subscribe. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you very much for your support. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you for engaging, and I really appreciate it. Number one, identify and choose the tech career you need. Well, I've worked for 4 years in the tech industry, and I can tell you that you don't know, or you can never know how to start. When I started looking for my first job, I was really clueless on how to start or where to go. So I started with the foundational, right? I was doing my Python programming as training, but before then, I wasn't able to get a job. But when I started it and I applied for entry-level positions, I got it, and I started as an IT support. There are so many areas in the tech industry, right? And the best way to have idea of almost everything that is involved. For example, if you have interests or you have like skills in design, you know, I think you should look at the user experience. If you like solving complex problems, I think programming or software development will be good for you. And if you love giving solutions to people, like you know how to communicate and, you know, give them try to solve problems for people, you know, IT support or customer support will be good for you. And if you love data, you like analyzing data, you know, you love bringing out data and, you know, converting it to an information whereby people can understand, data analysis is actually a good career path. IT has so many fields, like I mentioned. We have the information security, we have data analysis, we have software development, you know, we have system administration, we have database administration, you know, we have a lot of them actually, like that I cannot even mention. We have the user experience, we have the graphic designers, DevOps, you know, that's for the development and operations part of it. We have the cloud engineers. So there are a lot of fields in IT. Building foundational skills, learning and practicing, like that is how we can actually pick up this thing, because you always have new problems to tackle every day, because you can't come across one kind of problem every day. We have several problems that we get to tackle, and if you don't have that foundational background of all these issues, it's going to be very hard for you to actually like pull through. So you have to be open to learning the basics of everything, even if it means taking basic level courses and trainings or entry-level job like I started in my career. You need to try that. That is how I got to start, and it worked for me, because I was open to networking, I was open to database, I was open to you know, customer support. When you get that confidence with the foundational part, you can now move to the specialized part, where you get to choose any tech niche and just specialize. So your ability to rise in this tech ladder is your willingness to learn and your openness to actually, like, you know, learn and get a lot of skills. There are so many learning platforms that I know about which are free, like Sololearn, W3 School, which is amazing, Microsoft Learn for Microsoft courses, Learn, Simplilearn is absolutely good. We have Cisco Academy for you know, cybersecurity or network professionals. Because if you want to go into the software part of IT, you need to be very good with your programming, like C, C++, C#, Java, Python, you know, on a, you just need to hone, and there are a lot of programming languages, right? But these are like the major ones that are really common and popular. Also, communication and collaboration. If you're working in IT, just remember that you get to work with teams, like you get to work in a team, and if, for you to work in a team efficiently, you need to learn how to communicate. If you're a customer support person, you need to learn how to communicate, but especially verbally and in writing. The third one is getting education, right? I know that a lot of courses or a lot of jobs out there may not require a bachelor's or a college degree, but trust me, when you see a lot of job descriptions right now, they will actually put it there that you need to have a bachelor's degree either in computer science or in information technology or in computer engineering or other related courses, you know, depending on the job description. So let me tell you, a degree is very, very important because it makes you really attractive. It makes you it makes your employer convinced that you have the foundational level of, you know, of that job you're trying to apply for. So if you're already working a full-time job and you don't have time to go, you know, for a college degree, there's nothing wrong in signing up for a bootcamp that you can get the foundational skill and knowledge for you to, you know, get that good job you need. And the fourth one is getting experience. Experience is very, very important. Like, it's actually the key in tech industry. Like, people don't really like employing fresh starters, like most time for critical roles. They rather go for people that have experience. And how can you be a very good candidate with practical experience? In general, in order to gain this experience, you need to actually pay the price of it by signing up for internship or freelancing jobs where you work closely with IT professionals. You need to be certified. That's the fifth one. You need to be certified, because for you to be certified, why apply for a job? You know, you just tell your employer that you have the skills required. You don't have to start putting everything down. Just putting that you've accomplished this certification says it all, to be honest. I know it's a bit pricey. Yeah, certifications are pricey, and a lot of companies actually support their employees in signing up for some of these trainings and certification exams, which I applaud them for, and some companies don't. And when they don't, and you work in this kind of companies, do not be discouraged. I know it's going to take a lot for you to save up money to write the certification. I have these Microsoft trainings that come, virtual trainings that come about, and once you sign up to for these trainings, like, you get to have vouchers to write the certification exam. Thanks to Microsoft for doing that, because they actually like help people that don't know how to raise that amount of money, you know, for that period of time to write the certification. So when you just sign up to this virtual trainings, you get this voucher, and you know, you sign up, you read, you pass, and you get your certificate. Certification actually makes you stand out, makes you more valuable, it makes you more recognizable, especially the globally accepted certification. Network and seeking out mentorship. Networking is important too, let me tell you. And it's actually very key in the tech industry, because we have conference meetings, we have boot camps, which I've mentioned before. You know, we have industrial events, which you get to sign up, you get to join, you meet people, you meet professionals, you meet people that are, you know, way advanced. You know, you get to rub minds together, you get contacts, you can reach out to them for mentorship later on, reach out to them if they have openings in their job, you reach out to them if they have free trainings where you can sign up for to get these skills. Once you have a mentor, you know, through this networking, you get to look up to this person and you see all what they've achieved, how the steps they took, and it gives you an edge on how to start yours. So the seventh one is staying updated with these technology trends. Technology is rapidly changing and growing fast, right? And if you don't stay updated, I'm sorry, like, you're gonna have a lot of issues. For example, Windows 7 now is no more releasing updates. There are updated operating systems like Windows 8, Windows 9, Windows 10, Windows 11. You just notice that a lot of your applications on your system are failing. You can't do your work efficiently and diligently. But when you are updated, you know that this new update is out now. It's time for you to do an upgrade. Reading industrial news, taking online courses, attending conferences as well. That's how you get to be updated and staying engaged in this tech community. So even the tech community too, you get to be updated when there are new trends and new technologies are coming out. The eighth one is tailor your resume to the kind of job you are looking for. If you see a job out there, you know, where the employer lists out the responsibilities and he mentions that you should know how to resolve problem and analyze and resolve problem, you need to make sure in your resume, you should put out your accomplishments, you know, where where you state that your previous place of work, you actually came across this problem, you analyzed it, and you resolved this particular problem or this project. So you finished up this project. So it's just very, very easy, and it makes you seen. If the job description involves troubleshooting and networking, if it involves design and implementation, you need to make sure your resume is tailored according to it, so that it's going to be easy to be whitelisted when they are actually like streaming the candidates for that kind of job. As much as possible, back up your claims with your accomplishment in your resume. Please back it up. Make sure you make it look juicy. Let your employer see your value. Just continue. It's not easy. I started with IT support, I did networking, I did database, I did almost everything as a whole in IT support, and it was easier for me, to move somewhere else. And so just thank you for watching this video, and I hope that my next video I'll put out great jobs that are really, really hot and trending in 2023. So thank you for watching. Much love. Take care of yourself and be good. Thank you.